Hey, folks, coming up on this episode of Florida Sweets and Treats, tasty pastry that has delighted people for centuries. Welcome to Florida Sweets and Treats. I'm your host, Chef Costa Magoulas. Pastry evolved all over Europe, and each country has its own tradition of delicious confections. We're going to enjoy some of those tonight with the help of my lovely wife, Yvan.
Hello.
And we got a special guest with us tonight, Anwar Shahab of Pasha's Cafe, one of my favorite places in town. Anwar, welcome.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Oh, it's great. You know, we got to talk about the restaurant tonight. I just love the things that you do there.
Yeah.
You want to tell me what kind of desserts that you really enjoy making there?
Baklava.
Baklava. And, everybody likes baklava.
Yeah, so many good. Different type of nuts and also delicious katayifi dough.
Katayifi is almost like the baklava, except little skinny.
Shredded. It's a shredded dough.
You know what I like about the desserts?
Different.
The Middle Eastern desserts are healthy for you.
The best.
You know, because we were talking about that earlier. You know, it's all natural.
Yes, it is.
And you were telling me about rose water.
Rose water is so good.
Well, let me get everybody started here. Tonight, it's a call-in show. That means you folks have to call in at 1-800-901-9238. I keep teasing everybody about this, but they ought to get a plaque and put it on the wall in their home, so all they have to do is look up and call. So give us your calls about desserts tonight, about the Middle East. But we're going to be doing a lot of things tonight and talking about these great desserts. They're fantastic. I mean, I'm looking at it, and I want to grab something all over the place. But before we do that, we're going to do a little something. We're going to look at you making some baklava.
All right.
That's going to be
favorite.
Exciting.
Yeah.
It's authentic Middle Eastern baklava made by Anwar right now.
Pasha Cafe. In the heart of Daytona Beach lies a little corner of the Middle East where you can find the authentic baklava. Today, Anwar Shahab shares his time-tested recipe from the lands of the Arabian Nights. After preparing the pan, pairs of layers of phyllo dough are quickly placed on the pan. These layers must each be covered with low-fat margarine, so after the pastry is baked, the dough will stick together and be able to hold the nuts. The phyllo dough must extend beyond the sides of the pan so that they can fully envelop the pastry's delicious filling of walnuts, a little bit of sugar, and cinnamon to give it that little added flavor. Then again, the mixture is sprinkled with low-fat margarine and a second set of phyllo dough layers is placed on top the same way they were prepared for the bottom. Before the baklava can be baked, it must be cut and cut precisely after making sure that the long cuts go all the way through and are also spaced out evenly, it's time to turn the pieces into little squares. If the phyllo doesn't want to cooperate, you still have to make sure that the cut goes all the way through. Otherwise, they will stick together when they come out of the oven. The third cut turns the squares into little triangles. This is called the Greek cut. Goes in the oven, and when it's golden brown, it's time for the last part of the process. The baklava has to be hot and the syrup must be cold. That mixture of water, sugar, and lemon gives each piece that rich, tangy flavor. It looks good. It tastes even better.
Boy, I tell you what, that baklava looked good, didn't it?
Oh,
yeah, and delicious. The way you were, you know, we were talking while everybody was watching that.
Yeah.
Alma and I were talking about how you need a sharp knife to cut the baklava,
exactly.
Okay? That's
absolutely
important.
Absolutely, very important.
Oh, boy. And the way you cut that was beautiful.
Yeah.
The pattern that you used, what was that you were telling me again?
They call it a Greek cut.
Greek cut.
Yeah.
You know, being Greek, I thought I'd know that, but I don't.
There is a diamond cut and square cut and triangle cut and rectangle. So many different cuts.
You know,
the easiest one is a Greek cut.
Well, you were telling me that they also have some of these, I guess, manufacturers have a machine that cuts
machine,
it?
Machine, yes.
But you prefer the knife, right?
Yeah, well, of course.
Old school.
Yeah, old school is the best.
Listen, folks,
home
don't
remedy business.
This is a call-in show, 1-800-901-9238. We want you to call in and talk to us about these desserts because we're going to talk about it some more. And I'm going to ask, he's got some great knowledge. If you haven't been down to Pasha's, you really need to go there, I'm telling you. It's a fan plant. You can just walk around and see all the different things. You know, I was there at your store the other day, and you made me some lemonade, didn't you?
Yes.
Oh, tell them how you made that. I took a taste of that. I said, what in the world is that lemonade?
It's fresh lemon.
Yeah.
With water and ice and sugar water and orange blossom. Orange blossom is a really nice natural drink, refreshing.
Oh, it
especially
truly
summer,
is.
It any time of the year.
It's
delicious.
It truly is. You know, tonight my wife is with us, Yvonne. You know, I probably blew over her tonight because I was so excited about Alma being here with us. She's joining us a little bit, too.
Thank you.
Great.
You know, I've got to ask you something. What's your favorite pastry?
My favorite pastry is on this table. It's the lakumi there at the end of the tray.
You mean this one here?
Yes, that one there. And that one,
delicious.
What this is it's like a soft jelly, and it has nuts, pistachios, right?
Yes,
mostly.
It is.
And then they just roll it in powdered sugar, and it's just delicious.
It's delicious nut.
You know what's nice about, we were talking earlier on about how healthy the Middle Eastern food in general is. And,
yes.
You know, you were telling me about the sesame seeds. Tell me a little bit more.
Sesame seeds, the most popular thing in the Middle East. They can do hummus with tahina and baba ghanoush. And also they can make a sauce like a fish.
Oh, really?
You put it in a sauce or salad. It's a marvelous thing in the Middle East.
Well, we got
very popular.
A few things here tonight we were just messing around with. We have the lakum, we have some figs, and we have
delicious.
Some dates. I mean, that's big. Everybody, you want to have dessert, have simple fruit with some nuts maybe. And then we have some sesame cookies, right? Is that what that
yes,
is?
It is?
And then the halva, which is made out of sesame too, isn't
sesame.
It?
Sesame with sugar.
You know, my father, when he got up in the morning, I swear he would just have some cheese, and he would get some grapes, and he'd get some figs. How healthy is that? I mean, if
this
you ate like that.
The best breakfast, and very tasty breakfast, and fully. And away from additive. This is the most important thing.
I like to add a nice, strong cup of coffee.
Oh, yeah.
go
we
with.
Got a call came in from, I believe, Buddy from Orlando. Are you there, partner?
Yes, hello.
Hey.
I am.
What's your question?
Hey, I had a question. Early on in the episode, you seemed very excited about rose water, and I wanted to know what the benefits were or what that added to the dish to make it, you guys so excited about it.
Yeah, I want to tell him about rose water because we were talking about it earlier. It really does a lot of things. He asked about rose water.
Rose water is very natural stuff, you know, it all distills water. And
it's distilled water from the roses?
From the roses, they boil the roses and distill it little at the time, and such a beautiful taste and refreshing, and especially for women, they wash the face in the morning.
Really?
And you can drink it, and no problem, no side effect all natural.
Well, you know, you were telling me that when you wash, it really is good for you.
Yes, especially they have two different kinds. There is rose water and there is orange blossom water also.
Orange blossom water?
Orange blossom water even
greater. Man, that sounds good.
And especially hot summer, you wash your face with it a little bit. And you drink a little bit around the neck, you put a little bit around, and you see the magnificent change of instant refreshing.
You know what's going to happen?
God goodness, all special.
Everybody's watching the show tonight, they're going to go out and buy rose water.
Yeah, why not?
Orange blossom water, we know where to
keep it in your pocket, too.
Well, it's got health benefits, so that's what amazes me. Is
very
just
good, very powerful stuff. And everyone's supposed to know about rose water.
Well, they don't, I'm telling you.
And orange blossom. That, too, is a miracle.
That orange blossom, that's the first I've heard of that. That sounds fantastic. Yeah. A lot of people use that in their pastries all the time?
They use it in the pastries, and also they use it on, rice pudding.
Oh, really?
And, okay. Yes, and a lot of different sweet.
Well, I'll tell you what,
nice,
it made a difference.
Pleasant taste.
Well, that wonderful lemonade you made me drove me crazy. I was going, oh, that is so good.
Because all natural.
Yeah. Well, we got another call tonight, and it's Hazel from Winter Park. What's going on over there, Hazel?
Hi. We always thought that baklava was made with honey, but when we saw you preparing it, no honey was used. So we were just hoping you could clear that up for us.
Well, we're talking about the syrup that you put in the baklava. Yeah, Chef, what do you think about that?
Syrup is simple. You can do sugar water or honey, and you mix it with a little bit of orange blossom water again. It's option, but it gives a nice taste, really authentic taste.
So you can use either honey or do the simple syrup,
right?
You can
do either or, yes.
I hope that answers your question, Hazel. That answered mine, too. I'll tell you, I love orange in baklava. I think it's fantastic in that. We kind of used the rinds from it and everything.
You can, yeah.
Again, really when you're looking at these desserts we're talking about and the Middle Eastern food, it is so healthy for you. I mean, come on. We were talking about lamb earlier, right?
Lamb, wow. It's a magnificent thing in the Middle East.
But now the big trend here in the country is vegetables and vegetarian. And Middle Eastern falls right into that because you were talking. What was that my son loves so much? Falafels.
Falafel, all natural ingredient, also has no any preservative.
No preservatives, that's
all
great.
All grain and vegetable. They call it vegetarian burger.
Vegetarian. And, it tastes great.
They're really very, does. Very famous in Middle East. And Egyptian, they call it tomiya.
Well, we got another call from Eddie in Port Orange. Hello, Eddie.
Hey, how you doing, Chef?
Doing great.
Hey, good. I wanted to know, what is the most popular dessert in the Middle East?
The most popular dessert in the Middle East?
Okay, the baklava, the most popular one, because they make, Middle East, they make it many different nuts. They have walnut, pistachio, hazelnuts, pine nuts. This is amazing. You heard about
pine nuts.
You put pine
nuts in it, really?
Oh, delicious.
I don't think I've tried that. I'd like the pistachios.
It's not available much in the pine nuts and highly expensive.
Yeah, they are. They really are. I tell you what, I'm just thinking here, all the nuts and things that we do, natural foods, sure is going to make you feel better, isn't it?
Absolutely.
You know, folks, this is Call-In Show. Don't forget, 1-800-901-9238. Now, we were talking about vegetarian dishes. You know, the falafels is one of my son's favorites. Do you serve that in pita bread or not?
Yes, we put falafel, we make it from scratch, everything natural, gluten-free. That's the most important thing. We put lettuce, tomato, and parsley, a lot of curly parsley, and also we put some cucumber. Pickle.
Oh, that sounds good.
Makes it really tasty. And the most famous thing is tahini.
Yeah.
Tahini, it's a sesame, all natural sesame tahini paste with lemon, sea salt, and fresh lemon.
Wow, that sounds good.
Sea salt and water.
That really does sound good.
You mix it together, makes it really, really good.
Well, you got the grains in there and the vegetables, and you got the protein as well, so it's
absolutely
high in protein.
Yes.
Okay, come on. You eat like this all your life, and, folks, you'll be great. Instead of having a bag of chips or something, come on and eat some really decent food.
And falafel is really, it fill you up.
Oh, that sounds...
big meal.
Well, folks, don't forget, 1-800-901-9238. We're going to do a couple little things here tonight. We're in no rush to do it because we're having fun talking about the Middle Eastern food. One of the things we were talking about earlier was when you're dealing with Middle Eastern food, you're dealing with a lot of flavors that are all natural.
And very healthy.
That is the biggest thing in today's society. We're talking from farm to table, so all fresh vegetables, all fresh ingredients. I'm looking in front of me right here with these different things. The sesame seed, using so many different things. You know that little sesame cracker they make?
Yes.
Yvonne loves, she comes and gets
some. I used to make those there with sesame honey.
Cracker.
It's honey syrup, and then you fold in the sesame seeds, the toasted seeds,
you
and
can.
Then you just lay it out and then cut it into little bite-sized things.
You ever tried dates, you know, without the seed. Dates.
Oh, really?
You mix the dates. And you put some inside. There you go.
Okay. There you go. There's a date.
A date.
You mix it with the sesame?
Almond inside.
Oh, yes.
Or you mix it together.
Mm-hmm. Oh, wow.
And you put sesame seed around.
Oh, okay.
And
that's a nice
also
treat.
You put coconut. It's coconut.
Coconut. Really?
Very healthy.
Oh, my goodness. We're sitting here. I'm looking at these sesame seed cookies and the dates. I'm going, wait a minute now. You get that all put together. What a great dessert that is.
These dates
natural.
Are wonderful.
Look, she's
very
eating
powerful.
The dates.
I'm
going to
taste everything.
I'm loving it. Well, you know, we're talking about baklava. Baklava has such a rich history. It goes back 2,000 years. I mean, the early Persians, and they started with the phyllo dough and brought it down through history. So now we have it in today, and it's gone down through history. I think it's just amazing. And it was all fresh things then.
That's exactly right.
I didn't bring any phyllo dough to the show tonight, but it's almost like paper, isn't it? I was watching when you were making the baklava.
Yeah.
You had the pan there. Do you have so many sheets that you put on the bottom and so many on top? Does
yes.
it matter?
Does, of course, because you don't want to burn the nuts.
Oh,
everything
okay.
has to be sealed.
Okay. Yeah, I noticed you folded it over. That's the first time I've seen it, because most people do the top. And I like that idea. I really, Yvonne's going.
I do. I make mine a little differently. So I picked up a great tip watching the clip earlier. So I'm going to try that next time I make baklava.
Yeah, well, simple. Makes everything simple.
Mm-hmm. That's right. Folks, what we're going to do right now, just don't forget to call in. We're still listening, all right? We're going to do what we call loukoumades. That's a popular dessert. Every culture has a fried dough of some kind. And the Greeks have this thing they call loukoumades. It's a fried dough, has buttermilk in it and yeast and things. And we're going to cook a few of those tonight. And we're going to show you. I already made the batter up. And Yvonne, no, you can't have any right now.
I'm going to taste them later.
Yeah,
guaranteed.
I figured you would.
Oh, wow. And with honey, a little bit of cinnamon.
Mm-hmm. We're going to fix this one up here in just a minute.
Yummy.
Yep. My grandmother used to make these for breakfast.
You have
for us.
To make sure you turn around so they brown real good and everything. Got to let this cook for a minute. But if you've ever been to any of the local festivals, the Middle Eastern festivals, you'll probably see a fried dough item like this.
Oh, yeah.
And what they do, Yvonne, you got that plate there, please?
Mm-hmm. There you go.
And what I'm going to do here in a minute when it's done, it's still cooking away, all right? No, you can't eat it right away. The gang out there is going, well, that smells pretty good. Doesn't that smell good? Well, we got Jane
something.
From Oviedo on the line. You there, Jane?
Yeah. Can you give Greek tours?
Excuse me?
Do you offer Greek tours?
Oh, yes, I used to.
During.
I used to do the Greek tours all the time. Did you go to the church and do that? I'm losing you. Where'd you go? Well, when I can, it's just a scheduling thing that I have. And it's hard for me to get away anymore. And I used to do it like Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. I used to love doing them and talking to everybody. Because when you look at those churches, especially the Orthodox Church, Greek Orthodox, it's very traditional. They have all the beautiful paintings inside. And it's really, they call them icons. It's kind of nice. Anyway, we're almost done with these lucumadas here. I had a little problem. This pan here was sticking. I wasn't watching what I was doing. So I'm going to take this one. I'm going to toss it. Don't forget, folks, our number is 1-800-901-9238. Yvonne, you got something over there.
I started making the Greek coffee or Turkish coffee.
Right.
Now we're
That's
talking.
Wonderful.
Tell them what you did.
Demitasse.
In a demitasse, we put water, and we measure the water by using the demitasse cup. So we, because it's a very small pot, we call it a briki.
Yeah.
Before you go any further, I got to say something. Bought some beautiful cups from Anwa at his store,
yeah.
But she wouldn't let me bring them down.
I didn't want to take the chance they break.
Beautiful cups. So she made me bring the plain
really
cups
nice
down. So, okay, I didn't mean to interrupt.
And
so,
then I just put a heaping teaspoon of...
Now, it's important to... Well, tell them how you're doing that. That's okay.
And this is stone ground, so it's very fine.
Stone ground coffee.
And it's very strong, but it cooks quickly in this little pot. You
that's
bring it to a boil.
That's why you don't drink it in the big cup.
Right, but you'd stay up
you
for
mind.
24 hours.
Now, isn't there a technique to cooking that?
I was taught to let it come to a boil 3 times.
Okay.
And by doing that, it creates a nice foam on the top. So you want to get, when you're pouring the coffee out, you want to get a little foam into each cup.
Very good.
Well, there these lucumadas are coming out.
To do it.
I actually finally got them. I think my little pan in there got stuck on me a little bit. See how it's all messing up? So I'm not going to use this pan anymore. Yeah, that was my fault. I wasn't paying any attention, okay? I take the blame, but you know what? I was watching the coffee and running my mouth over here, but here's the critical part to this, okay? Isn't this it? Oh, you get that cinnamon on there, that fresh cinnamon. And then you get fresh honey.
Oh,
you put that honey
really
on
delicious.
There. Yeah, we get, oh, yeah.
All right.
Now we're talking. All right, guys, you need to stay out there, relax a minute. They'll be ready soon. Don't forget, folks, our call-in show at 1-800-901-9238. We're having some fun here with Middle Eastern desserts and foods. Yvonne's doing something with that coffee. I'm not sure what.
It's boiling now.
How long does it take to cook? Actually, it's cooking pretty fast.
I've got a high flame here, so this little stove is pretty powerful.
Okay, how do you know when it's done now?
Well, it'll boil up to the rim of the briki, and then you'll want to just pull it away so it doesn't boil over. And you have to do it very quickly.
There's different traditions.
Keep an eye on it.
I know in our culture... They say bring it to a boil 3 times. It's supposed to be Father, Son, and Holy Ghost kind of a thing with the religion. But each culture is different.
Like with the foam?
Right. See, it's
there
creating
you go. See the foam
by boiling that up.
Okay.
And then just let it settle a little bit. And I'm going to do it one more time because that's the way I was taught.
Okay.
She's going to bring it to a boil 3 times. Then you put it directly into the cup, and you drink it like that.
If you need the foam, you don't want to boil it 3 times.
Oh, okay.
Really?
So tell me your trick.
Oh, I just learned something.
Yes.
That's good.
If you don't want the foam, if the foam disappears, you boil it 3 times, the opposite way.
Okay, there you go. And that, I tell you, you got to have the foam, that crema on top.
Yeah,
oh,
the
that's
foam
beautiful.
Is very, very nice taste. Give
now,
it good
you know,
appealing.
It's very... Middle Eastern cultures, it's very important for desserts and sweets and coffee. Because you go into the home, and they're going to offer you something sweet when you walk in. And then, oh, thank you. Now, you can make this coffee different way. You can put sugar in it.
Yes, or without sugar. Whatever you wish.
I'd like it plain like this.
You don't want to put
milk. What if y'all saw this picture of this coffee?
Spoil it.
Now, I remember years ago... See ya.
Yes.
He's talking to me in Greek better than I do.
Very good.
Man, that's good.
Pouli oreo.
Pouli oreo. There you go.
Ευχαριστώ.
Yeah. Very good. Very good.
Well, you know, you can eat almost anything you want with this coffee. It just goes. There are a lot of, you know, our cultures, they actually just sit down and have coffee. They enjoy it. But they want to have something sweet with it. You can do all kinds of, any recommendations for with the coffee?
Any, well, you can eat any sweet will be fine.
Well, that sounds great. Well, you know, we have a lot of fruit out here, too, just to remind everybody that that is something we do all the time. Now, folks, I hate to say this, but it looks like that's all the time we have for tonight. Thank you, Evan. I appreciate it.
My pleasure.
I really appreciate you joining us tonight. It's really, get this glove off of here. Okay. If you're not able to get your questions answered, or feel free to email us at wdsctv@daytonastate.edu. And come on back next week for another fun episode of Florida Sweets and Treats. And I'm going to drink my coffee right now. Okay, gang?
Thank you.